got the lyrics to the cheer of the Puma team. We're gonna sing next time it happens.
Aztecs referred to Mexico City as the heart of the one world. Despite carrying the weight of 7 centuries of development, that heart still beating strong, sending blood through the main veins and avenues of Mexico DF, or Distrito Federal. With a population of just over 20 million, it's one of the most densely populated cities in the Western Hemisphere. Full of paradoxes, Mexico City is home to the old and the new, the rich and the poor. An advanced industrialized economy exists side by side with a bustling informal market. It is this very contrast that's prompted the nickname Defectuoso Federal, an apt way to describe life in a city where things rarely work the way you would expect. Yet amidst all this, there's definitely a vibrancy and a seductive charm strong enough to overpower Defeños and visitors alike. At least, this is our first impression. Chuck is a project of Alumnos 47, a foundation which seeks to bridge the gap between art and education. Run by a group of young changemakers, Alumnos 47 believes that contemporary art can be a catalyst for social change and development. Through their book truck, they aim to make art books accessible to every neighborhood across Mexico City.
But I mean, just in general, this is such a cool space.
It's so organized.
What goes on here exactly?
This is the main library, and this is where all team from the foundation get together, and then we incubate projects and ideas, and then we took them outside.
You talked about the group that comes together. That's Alumnos 47.
Yes.
Where does that name come from?
It's because of the street and the number of the house, actually.
Ah. So we are in Alumnos Street 47 number. Clever name for
foundation. Wow, awesome. Okay.
Okay, and what do you guys do? What does the foundation do?
We want to be like a center of knowledge, like around contemporary art.
You're doing something really cool on the weekends, which is you have that amazing truck.
Yes.
And you take that out and you stop in different locations and you invite people in.
We go to different communities and we get to publics we cannot aspire to come to a place like this.
When you say them, who are you talking about?
It's a tricky question because we have many targets. We have the public who is not specialized in art, like, I don't know, families and children, and the one that is.
Well, we designed some materials that help us relate the public to contemporary art themes.
Like, from the moment that you, like, rock up to a space, like, how does that whole process work?
It has to be a social active space.
We've got a movie library. Everything is free because that's really important. And we start talking to the children, to their parents, and we invite them to the library.
So we call that the picking children process.
Oh boy, is that legal?
Like different to construct a different space than a normal library, because libraries are always to be quiet and they are always clean.
And can people check out books?
Sure. Oh no.
Sorry. Agree to disagree.
No.
And why are you guys doing this?
I was called here to the foundation because I work with a group that we make workshops for constructing projectors. So Citlali called me to give a workshop here, and well, I was just in love with the project, and I was like, okay, I'm looking for a job, you know? So it's a beautiful job. Mm-hmm. I like it. It's like, after a while of visiting a neighborhood, you became like part of the landscape. So they come and they ask you to show them books, and they're really into it.
Also because it's fun and it's interesting and it's easy to get to people.
I love how like Los Arbos is right next to a bunch of Sigmund Freud books. Are we that messed up?
Oh, you are.
We are.
The crazy people are on that side.
Oh, the crew is over there. Mohammed's. I can imagine this would be Mohammed's favorite shop.
So we're here to find two masks, one for me and one for Payman.
And my brother would love a black mask, plain black, and it has a zipper over here.
He's kidding. I heard that this is a very old store. How old is the store?
They've had this store for 80 years now.
How long?
80 years.
80 years.
I think it was founded in 1933, right? Fundada en 1933. And his father was the inventor of the wrestling masks. The first mask ever made was in this store.
Tengo aquí la primera máscara hecha por mi padre.
He has the first mask they ever made.
He has it right
he
now?
He has it right
can
now.
Can we see it?
Yeah, we can see it. He's going to show it to us.
Esta es la primera máscara que hizo mi papá.
It's handmade.
How much is this sort of a mask worth?
He was offered $50,000 by Japanese people and he didn't take it.
Wow.
Thanks. It's
worth much more than that, yeah.
Oh my God. Tradición de México.
Says this is all Mexican pride because before everyone thought of Mexicans with a big sombrero, and now they think of Mexicans with masks.
Can we find the mask that will improve my brother's face?
Dice que si podemos encontrar una máscara que haga que se vea más guapo.
Definitivamente.
He said that I make masks, not miracles. Right? That's
something
what he
like
says.
That.
Mexico City is an assault on your sensory system, fueled by creative expression. At the forefront of this is Capital Mural, an art and culture collective whose intention is to regenerate interest in neglected neighborhoods through artistic intervention. Ricardo Beard and Paola Victoria talk to us about the impact this initiative has on people and community.
So Jason, what are we doing here?
So, we're here taking
Sorry,
a look.
Your name's not
I'm
Jason.
Not Jason.
Wait, you're not Jason?
Ricardo.
Wait a minute. Where's Jason?
Un saludo para mis carnales, o más bien dicho, es carnales de Dubai, desde México para Dubai con fuerza, corazón y resistencia.
You're part of a collective, or you started it.
Yeah.
What is all that about?
It's called Cultura Colectiva. I didn't start it. I arrived a few months after it was started. We started about 2.5 years ago, and we basically started in a friend's couch, and we started out writing just different like notes about artists we liked and series they had done and just stuff like that.
And these are graffiti artists?
No, just in general. The point is to show people what they are not just looking for, you know? They really respond to it, they really like it, but they don't take the time to look for it. So that's kind of what we're trying to do, just try to create this support platform like Defeños platform, mm-hmm. where artists like could get their work seen. And in 2 years, we've actually become the biggest, the most seen website on Defeños medium in Latin America. The sun is coming. The sun is coming. She shining this place. I know the local sun. I'm just a local. Well, I know.
Hola.
Hola, Paula. How are you?
How are you?
You didn't see this guy over here?
No.
How are you, Paula?
I snuck up on you. How are you?
Yeah.
All right.
Sorry.
We won't shake your hands.
How you doing?
How long have you been doing this?
For 3 days now. This mural in particular was asked to be done for the 140 years of the neighborhood, the Guerrero neighborhood.
Oh, wow.
And they asked me to do a little historical, you know, an interpretation of the history of the neighborhood. I'm working with Cultura Colectiva, particularly in their project of urban art, which is called Capital Mural. And it's about recovering the muralism, right? Because Mexico used to be known for its muralism. It got very, very strong. It was very, very popular around the world. Like people used to, like New York City used to call the artists like Diego Rivera, who was the major, you know, artist who started this this current.
Paula, you're from this neighborhood?
No, actually my family is the owner of the Salon Los Angeles.
What?
Yeah, and so that's why I know the neighborhood, and I have spent almost my whole life in the neighborhood.
But what do people here feel about this, what you're doing?
They are curious, they like it. I think that it makes them feel special, right? Because someone is noticing, and they felt it before because they remodeled all the park and the plaza. And with this mural, it's also an invitation to the young people and the old ones to come and, you know, express themselves. And, you know, you can do it. It's not always illegal, or it's not always, you know, vandalism.
Paimon can't paint, by the way.
Come on, what?
I can use a paintbrush.
Can you?
Do you mind?
No.
Can we, like, paint with you?
Sure.
Are you sure you're going to trust him with a paintbrush?
Yes.
How am I doing, boss?
Great.
How you doing? You're doing well. You're doing well.
I said boss.
I know. You're doing well.
This area is called Xochimilco. It's in the south part of Mexico City. And it's built on a lake, so we're going to get in a trajinera.
Trajinera? What is that?
Trajinera is like a typical Mexican boat. And we're gonna get like a boat ride around the lake to see some typical Mexican stuff and hear people come to hang out, especially during the weekends because everyone works now.
The ship has sailed, Paimon. The ship has sailed.
People come here to hang out, to have food. There are bands playing live music. Maybe, if we're lucky, we'll get one.
Oh, I can see.
And a couple of sex. Do you want something to drink?
Yeah.
We can get a drink over here.
Sure.
Playing here and celebrate birthday.
He caught up with us.
Oh, he flew.
He flew. So people do this. If you want to buy food, you want to buy something to drink, people just hook their boats to ours and they sell what they need to sell and just
paddle
away.
The bands as well.
The bands as well.
They come on your boat.
Yeah. And they play. Of course.
Can we have a battle of the bands on the lake?
Yeah. Wouldn't it be an awesome shot if Muhammad just accidentally fell into the water?
No, I want to.
You mean like that, son?
It doesn't surprise us that young Defeños are teaming up to explore Mexico City's ripe entrepreneurial landscape. El Tercer Lugar is a specialty cafe and popular hipster hangout located in the Juarez neighborhood. It was brought to life by a chemical engineer, a biologist, and a chef. We managed to meet up with co-founder David Acco for a caffeine session at their coffee lab.
My man.
Hey, David. Welcome.
How's it going?
Fine, thanks.
You. I could smell this coffee from outside the building.
We just grind it. Fresh coffee.
Oh, nice.
So
that's music to my ears.
We're having a cupping. We're going to try.
Wait, what is cupping?
When we buy coffee and we work with the projects, we have to taste it all the time. So it's just an elegant way to say taste. Okay, so we're going to wait 4 minutes. Uh-huh. Then we're going to break, right? Right now, we just smelled them. And that's fragrance. And when we break it, we have the aroma of all the things that, like, they're already dissolved in water. We rest it for another 6 minutes, about 11 minutes, so it's not hot, and we try it.
You guys, I mean, you're doing something which is unconventional for a coffee shop.
Yeah.
I mean, your business model is slightly different. You're quite involved in the whole process of farming and everything, right?
Yeah, exactly. So that's the idea behind Buna, to bring all the chain, the coffee chain, from beginning to end within one group. That way we can guarantee quality, we can learn how to make the things better, and we can help every part of the chain.
Yeah.
Because they've become involved in this other part of the chain that before us they had no idea it existed.
So why did you decide to get into the coffee business?
Okay, coffee can be a model for social change, for economic change, and for agricultural change, right? So we're convinced that coffee, or through coffee, we can change society. And we love coffee. Like, we're passionate about coffee. Try that. Maybe that would answer your question, right?
Okay, is it time now?
Yep.
All right, so
this each one of us having one?
Oh. Okay, so.
So how does it work?
Every time you put in or out, you bathe it.
It's not soup.
Is that a good sound? Oh, sorry.
Dip. Make sure to make more sound.
Oh, more sound.
More noise, sorry.
He sounds like he's sucking petrol out of a car.
Listen, I'm just putting a little bit of a...
Why does it sound funny when he does it?
Listen, I made it a different sound so people know it's me.
Uh-huh. That's your signature.
And did you say that you're drying coffee on the roof?
Yeah, you want to see that?
Yeah.
Let's go. So this is it.
We're not going to fall through the roof, right?
No.
My God, it's amazing. So it's this little bean right here that you take out.
Exactly.
Oh my, all right, gotcha. So they're like pods. Awesome, thanks for showing us this.
Are we gonna
Let's try
this coffee shop? Yeah. I'm gonna leave that over there for you.
So if you can form a line here, Adrián is gonna make sure you don't have coffee. Yeah.
Yeah, that we're not sneaking coffee out.
Oh,
sneaky.
Beans away.
Smells fresh. It smells real.
Yeah.
Well, you know, a lot of people talk about the heartbeat of Mexico and how it's beating faster and faster with things happening here.
It's like a
because of this, man. You guys are making the brains
hard. You guys are fueling.
Yeah, coffee wakes the mind.
Are you guys gonna watch us drink coffee the whole day?
Look, P, as kids,
I hate to break it to you, but I used to let you win when we used to wrestle. But right now, we're here in Mexico, and it's payback time. And you have two choices. You either pray for your life, or you can call mom. It's your choice. And no matter what, you're going down.
Mohammed, you are somewhere here in this gym, working out on the 12th hour, thinking that you are gonna have payback for all those times when I pinned you down in our living room and on mom and dad's bed. It's not gonna happen now. You're my brother, man, I love you, but in this ring, every man for himself, and I'm telling you, you're going down.
Mexico City has endured its fair share of adversity. There's a lot of talk about violence and crime, but to be honest, we didn't see any of it. Maybe just a pinch, or should I say a punch, of sadism in the ring? What makes Defeños so special is their resilience and ingenuity for solving everyday challenges, a refusal to concede. We felt an obvious optimism here. It could be heard in conversations, seen painted on vibrant walls, tasted in bite-sized meals packed with giant flavors, and experienced while wrestling in the ring, Lucha Libre style, of course. The young thought leaders we met are staying true to the tradition of perseverance. They're finding ways to keep their city's heart beating strong. In the process, they managed to capture ours.
Okay. Good, yeah.